Hello everyone. So today again early morning crafting, and today I will make something different. Many people sometimes ago, actually many crafting people sometimes ago will make twisted rows. And I also made, but I will use all of my, so I don't have, and decided today made this rose, but people used only one piece of fabric and create this rose. I decided today made not ordinary twisted rows, Frankenstein twisted rows, so just because Frankenstein paper is connect different paper together, so I decided connect different piece of fabric together. So yesterday on evening I will make this piece and try to make this rows. One of the showed you, but the first I want to tell 2 point about this rose. So the first point, fabric. I will cut. You will see. You don't see great, but maybe this way. I will cut just some small piece. Connect this piece together and made one big strip tape. So what I will use? I will use my coloring coffee dyeing fabric, rusting lace, coloring fabric on juice and on something pink, I don't remember what I will use, but it's different piece of lace, different. So also yesterday evening I will make one of this lace, I mean fabric. So I will make one rose, and you will see different color of this rose. So it looks great, and it's possible to make some embellishment from this rose. So the second point is base. Here I will use just origami paper yellow, and use as a base and just hot glue. So I connect this rows together and I will have what I have. It's also possible to use some different things to base. So it's possible to use the first things just ordinary paper and hot glue. Or not hot glue, just tacky glue or ordinary glue. It's also possible to put on a circle some double side tape. Many people have a label, so it's also possible to create this rows on label. I will have somewhere here, but I don't remember where this label is. Someone send me on Happy Mail circle label. Oh, I have circle label. So I will try to make this rose on circle label, and this label have two and a half inch. It's actually biggest, but I will maybe now I will need smaller, so I just cut this label in half and create this my rows. So what I will make, just this. This piece I will cut it neat here. So I put my row, my center on the center of this piece and just twist ordinary way. Twist this rows and push my finger on my flower, actually. Just twist and push. And the last circle. So I cut my strip and now I cut my not want to grate, so I maybe used glue. Okay, stay. Okay, so I just cut this my paper, what I don't need. Stay, don't want. And now I must open mud patch, handmade mud patch, and put a little bit on my rose. Because I want made it much little bit interesting, and it's also great to connect little bit much your fabric together. So what I will want, I want to put some little bit glitter on it. Not much. So I will have this my another rose with glitter. So it's now must dry and I will have another. So now I will make another rows, and on this time I will use this my ordinary origami circle, but on this time I will put double side tape on my circle because my label not great to connect with fabric, so I used double side tape. I will cut this my circle. This paper from my circle. Okay. And I just now repeat my old process, but by the way, I will glue this my piece together from hot glue, and just because you will have fabric tacky glue, you will of course use this fabric tacky glue or something else. And by the way, if you will make this rose, you will also use on paper just some sort of gel. It's also great. So cut little bit this my center, put on the center of the my paper and twist. Twist and push, twist and push. for this sort of rose is also great to use on journal, junk journal, like a decoration or like a decorative element when you will make some decoration onto journal. I mean paper clip decorate, I mean decorate some tag, cover of this rose and other things. So it's enough. I put just a little bit glue on end of my fabric and glue on to paper, so it's great. Now once again Mod Podge and little bit of glitter. This time I will use silver. Not much, little bit. So I will have a second my twisted roll, and you will see not great, but you will see how color on this rose change just because different fabric. So here it looks bad. So okay, another circle. Again, repeat the process. So of course I will use this my fabric, but like I say, it's also great used strip of fabric when you will have a small strip and you will don't know what you will must made with this strip. So it's just you will so great to connect together and make something like a Frankenstein rows from this strip. So like a decorative element on to junk journal or use somehow else. So peel off my okay, this is enough. So just because you will make these rolls, you decided how big these rolls must be. So I don't need biggest. I need this smaller, so I made smaller. Okay. Once again, mud patch. And on this time, silver and I think red. Together. So it's now ready, looks like so. Okay, and I will have some another smaller piece. You will saw, so maybe I will use this piece now. And once again, double side tape. Cut a little bit this fabric. So if you will have something like I on this time, so your piece don't want to connect together, so this is not problem. Just made this edge small and put here and continue made your rows. So once again you will see. So maybe I will use this part with some lace. It's okay, everything is okay. I will put a little bit glue on my rows. It's not a problem. So continue to create . So it's now finish. I just cut, not need paper. I just glue this my end of my strip here on another side. Of course I will put some mod podge onto. And of course I will use again two different glitter, little bit silver and little bit red. So my rose embellishment on this time, not much, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is ready. So this is, and it's also great, like I say, to use like a decoration. Is also great to use to your strip, small of fabric, what you will don't know what made, just connect together and made this rows. It's also a great decorative element to different things what you will make. So I think this idea you will like, and you will make this Frankenstein rosettes or rose, I don't know. And also yesterday I will just, I put it here, yesterday I will just gessoed my some fabric, and when it dry, I will just cut circle and made this rows. And this is another idea for you, because it's just ordinary fabric, gesso and stamping, script stamp. And it looks great, and fabric is strong, just because gesso. And you will also try to make rows like this, only with fabric and some script stamp. It's really great idea. So this is two sort of rows what I wanted. I put it here, maybe that you will saw all of this. So this is two idea from rows. Frankenstein twisted rows and spiral circle spiral rows, but only with from fabric and stamping. And you will make this, try to make this, and you will like this idea. So leave comments as always, and to the next video. Bye.